Celtics blew a 24-point lead and fell to the Pelicans in OT, 120-115. With the loss, Boston drops back to 500 at 15-15 on the season. They're now 7-10 on the road. And Brad Stevens is concerned, Stephen A., rightfully so. So tell me this. Who do you think's most to blame for the Celtics' struggles?
Him and Danny Ainge. The fact of the matter is Danny Ainge, felt like he had the team in place. He didn't need to really, really go for it, go for the chip or whatever. There's no shame in trying to build a team around Jason Tatum and Jaylen Brown, but you did that, all right, and it's not panning out right now. And I have to look at Brad Stevens because, listen, I like Brad Stevens. I think that he's an exceptional basketball mind. I think that when he first arrived, he proved himself to be one of the young, innovative coaches in the game of basketball. He's a class act, class personified. I genuinely like him, and I genuinely respect him as a coach, and I think anybody who knows anything about basketball has to respect him. But in the end, when you have a star like Jason Tatum, and make no mistake about it, ladies and gentlemen, that brother is a star. Jason Tatum is a star, and guess what? So is Jaylen Brown. The bottom line is you should be better than a 500 team. Now, of course, we got to look at Kemba Walker. He's got to play better. He hasn't been consistent. He's been injury prone. We get all of that. That's played the role. But in the end, he's got to play better. It's up to Brad Stevens to figure that out. And when I look at Brad Stevens, here's what I see. I see a guy that knows the game of basketball, that can coach his butt off. My question is the motivational skills that he has available to him in his arsenal. Are you the kind of guy that can galvanize the troops and maximize the potential around you? Of course he's respected. Of course we look at him and know that he knows the game of basketball. He knows what the hell he's doing. But I'm talking about that leader of men that's able to peel something out of you that you might not even know is inside of yourself. The great, great coaches figured out a way to do that over the years. It would be Phil Jackson, the Zen Master. It would be Pat Riley, the Winner Within. It would be Mr. Fix-It, the great Larry Brown, who doesn't get mentioned enough, who's a Hall of Famer. You know, the Chuck Daly's of the world, God rest his soul, and what he was able to do with the Detroit Pistons. The list goes on and on. The Greg Popovich's, of course, we can't forget to mention him. It's something about you as a coach where you shove aside the X's and O's because everybody knows what the other is doing, that's able to peel something out from inside of you and say, okay, I'm going to maximize the potential, even the potential you didn't know you have. That is the element I have not seen from Brad Stevens. And I think the Celtics have reached a point where now it's called upon to find out whether or not Brad Stevens has that little extra something in him to get that little extra something from his players, the players around Jaylen Brown and Jason Tatum. I have not seen that yet. And as a result, I think you're going to hear a lot of noise about Brad Stevens. If this stuff continues in Boston with these guys struggling, you're going to hear a lot of people talking about why have we raved about Brad Stevens so much. They're going to be asking that question, fair or unfair. You got Jason Tatum and Jaylen Brown. This is the sport of basketball. You should not be a 500 team with two studs like that.
I don't think this is a Brad Stevens issue. You want to blame someone off the court? You can blame Danny Ainge. And Danny Ainge blamed himself a couple days ago. He talked about roster construction. He may have to make a move. I'm going to get to that in a second. You want to blame someone on the court? You can blame Kemba Walker. Look, he has a bad knee. Kemba has a bad knee. And he is known as a tough guy and a real leader. And so my sense is that a lot of guys probably wouldn't be playing if Kemba's playing like this as a result of the knee, but of course he wants to play through. Look, the Celtics as constructed, they're a good team, and it's not that they're not a deep team. Like Robert Williams, that's a find, you know? He can really long and he can play defense, and Tice is a good player, and they have good players. Marcus Smart, who's out right now, is a good player, but these are all essentially defensive players. When you look at the roster, it's not deep. Offensively, you have two excellent wings in Tatum and Brown. And you're right, Stephen, it's more than a lot of teams have. But a lot of other teams would have more depth in terms of various players who can score. Obviously not on that level, but who can go get you some points, can go get you some buckets. The Celtics don't have that. They're really relying on Kemba to be that other guy offensively. And when he's not, where do the Celtics get the points from? It's hard. You know, like, where do the Celtics get the points from if not Tatum and Brown? And it's not like Tatum and Brown aren't giving you the points. It's not like Brad Stevens isn't doing things to create opportunities for them and to kind of optimize, to maximize what they have. He is, and they are. They're great, and everyone knows it. But who else is there? It's supposed to be Kemba. If Kemba is right, we talk about big threes. That's a legit big three if Kemba's right. He has not been Kemba Walker. And when Kemba shoots like he does last night, you're not going to win. A couple games ago, then you might win, right? That's what it is. I can't look at Brad Stevens and say that's on him. I'll say it's – I don't even like to say it's on Kemba because I think he's hurt. But if you want to blame someone on the who's actually playing, you can point to Kemba Walker. When he doesn't hit shots, very tough for them to win. You want to point to someone off the court? Danny Ainge.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.